Safaricom via M-Pesa and Visa have partnered to create the M-Pesa Visa virtual card. And today I'll show you how to create one and how to use one. So to create your card, you just enter into your M-Pesa application and look for Global Pay. Global Pay will be in the services. So open Global Pay. And you can see the M-Pesa Visa virtual card. If you want, you can select another color and image to go with your card, but I'm going to skip all that and just click on Create Card. Immediately, you will receive a flash message with your card number confirming that you have just created a brand new card. There are no charges to create this card, and it has an expiry time of only 3 years. These are my card details, and for obvious reasons, I have to hide them, so I'll try to use these details to pay for my Netflix subscription. I'll just pay for the standard. So this is where I'm stuck. There appears to be a problem with the payment method you are trying to use. So I don't know what the problem is, because the CVV number is what is the problem with paying for my Netflix subscription. The CVV number is only available for around 30 minutes. This is to prevent fraud. So this means that if someone has your card details, they cannot use any money in your M-Pesa account because they have to generate another CVV number, which is only generated in your M-Pesa Global Pay application. Another very good thing about this is that you have actually copy card details and you can paste them to whatever site you are trying to play. So this card actually works for services outside of Kenya. So you won't be able to pay for Kenyan services using this card. For that, you'll be just required to use your M-Pesa Paybill and Till Number services. So for things like Amazon, Netflix, maybe Prime, you can use this card, but you can't use this card to pay for things like Jumia here in Kenya. So what are the charges of using this card? I'll post this link from techarena.co.ke in my video description below. So what are the charges for using M-Pesa Visa virtual card? According to Safaricom, there will be no charges for using the card, but prevailing forex rates apply. Safaricom will also apply a forex charge markup of 3.5% on the prevailing forex rate to exchange from billing currency, Kenya shillings, to the currency at the time of purchase. So some other important points to note, I've already said some of this, but Fuliza will not be available for M-Pesa Global payments, and the virtual card does not store money, it just mirrors your M-Pesa balance. This is 2 days later, I was trying to pay for my Netflix subscription again, and this is the message that was printed on Netflix. There was an error processing your payment information. Please check that all fields are filled out correctly and try again. At the same time, I received this message from Global Pay. Dear customer, we have noticed an attempt to complete a repeat payment from Netflix International BV. To complete these payments, enable repeat systems in the M-Pesa card menu. So I don't know why this message came, because my Netflix subscription, that money never went through. So I tried to pay for Amazon Prime. Amazon Prime accepted my card details and they charged me 82.80 Kenya shillings to Google temporary hold. So I was having problems with Netflix, not with my M-Pesa Visa card. So indeed, you can see that this card works. So that's it. Thank you for watching. I hope you learned something new today. Let's meet in the next video and goodbye.